All right, we're gonna make some glögg tonight. My great grandparents from Sweden, my great grandfather was from Sweden, they used to make glögg. In fact, I talked to my uncle yesterday and he vividly remembers them making the glögg. So I'm gonna show you guys how to make glögg tonight. So,
ingredients, we have some port wine. We have some brandy, which I kind of drank a little bit of it last night. And then some Everclear, put a little punch in it. We have some glögg spices. This has got like cinnamon, cardamom, almonds, some fruits in there. I like to put some extra raisins in because it soaks up all the alcohol and flavor, and they're kind of nice to have. And then a couple beers we're gonna start simmering. We're gonna start simmering the spices in the beer, actually. And we're going to pour a couple beers in. This is actually my favorite bargain beer, Point from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. And what we're gonna do is turn the stove on. Okay. And then we're gonna throw some spices in here. Here you go, you can take a look at what the glögg spices look like.
There's a bag.
I'm gonna dump one in. And then I've got another one here. And we're gonna dump the second bag in. We're gonna let this simmer for, I don't know, at least, I have to look at the recipe, but I know this is gonna simmer for about 10 minutes. We really don't want it to boil, but we just want it to simmer. What we want to do is get the spices to kind of infuse itself into the liquid. So, take a look in there. So,
I can add a little bit of water to that too. Raise another beer if I wanted to.
All right, so this spice mix has been simmering for about a half hour, okay? And take a look in there.
And you'll notice that some of the fruit and some of the spices have actually soaked up some of that beer liquid, which is nice. And then we've got 2 gallons of the port wine. And we are going to dump these both in. Turn up.
Then we're going to turn up the heat a little bit. We don't want to boil it. We want to get it to a simmer. And I think it goes for another half hour in this process. Okay, so more port wine. I don't think it matters what kind. This is just your run-of-the-mill port. Put the heat up now. Keep an eye on it. Bring it to a simmer. And let it do for another half hour. All right. Our little port wine mixture has been simmering at least a half hour. And the next step is 32 ounces of brandy. I've got some nice Corbel here. And that's going to go in. Let's see. All right, so we're gonna do this, actually 2 of these. So this is, ooh, that's going good. Look at the simmer on that. So you got your spices and your port wine. It's actually probably a little
probably should turn it down just a little bit. So there's some brandy.
I'm gonna put another brandy in, and this is the point where I'm gonna put in some raisins as well. Raisins is optional, but they soak up the alcohol, and people like to fish them out of the glug and eat them, and they're pretty good. So I'm gonna add one more of these brandies. So 32 ounce total, added to the 2 gallons of the port wine and the spice mix. So another half hour will be ready for the next step. It's coming along very nicely.
Ooh, that's simmering. That's actually a little more than what I want. I'm gonna turn it down just a little bit.
Okay, so it's nice and aromatic and boozy. Whoa, okay. So really good stuff. Our next step after the port, brandy, spice mix is Everclear. So this whole bottle is gonna go in basically. And this is 190 proof grain alcohol. As if the brandy wasn't boozy enough. For the last drop. All right, last step. So basically simmer that we've started with the beer and the spice mixer, simmering that for, what was that, 20 minutes or something like that? And then it was the port and the spice mixture for 30 minutes simmering. Then it was another 30 minutes with the brandy. Last step is the Everclear, and that is just 10 minutes. And then it'll be ready in one last step, and that's to light her up, so.
Oh, ooh. Jesus Christ, that's how much alcohol in it. Do you want to smell that?
All right, you ready?
Oh my God.
Let's light her up. About 20 seconds.
Oh shit. I'm just kidding.
You getting that? Don't burn your phone. So we're gonna burn off some of this alcohol for, I don't know, 20 seconds or so. It's got a nice blue flame, nice and hot. That's probably about... Hi.
What happened?
And now we're ready to bottle and sample.
Oh, Jesus. Woo!
I think you might get too strong, Paul.
You can never make glug too strong.
This is an official recipe here.
Give you some raisins.
Does your mom say something or not?
Yes,
she can. Oh, she can see it? Yeah. Okay.
So, this was just on fire just a minute ago, so.
Here.
There you go. Get Travis's reaction.
It's pretty good.
Glug turned out very well last night. Had a good time making it. Travis made some amazing goulash with dumplings, so we kind of made a nice night of it here. But back to the glug, this really isn't indicative of yield, as Travis and Kelly took home a couple liters. So we got more out of it than what you see here. But one thing for sure, I will not use these plop top bottles again, because stuffing all that fruit in there is difficult, and getting it out again when you're serving it, it's gonna be a pain. So that's the last time I'm gonna be doing this. This is the way to go. And you can see all the fruit in the bottom of these, okay? A lot of fruit in there. Okay, so that's gonna be a problem that. I found some mason jars we had laying around and cleaned them up, and that's the way to go. So next time I do it, I'm going to go to Farm and Fleet and buy a bunch of mason jars. And this is a bunch of fruit I had over. It's almost like pure raisins and apricots and some prunes in there. And I took that out of the bottom of that stock pot last night, scooped it up and put it in there. And then I poured it up to the top with brandy again. So What I'm thinking I'm going to do is use that on Christmas morning and put that on the French toast, and that'll be really good. That might be just a new tradition I started in the family. And for serving, I like these glühwein glasses. I picked them up at Christmas markets over the years. These are from Germany. My favorite ones are in the dishwasher now, those boots. Picked those up in Nuremberg. These are from Chicago. But that's kind of the in Christmas markets in Germany. Glühwein is very similar to Glögg. It's just not as strong. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you have any questions about how to make it, or you have your own recipes, because Glögg is kind of like goulash in that there's probably 1,000 different recipes. So you may have your own and you may not like it as strong. So, but we like it. So have a Merry Christmas, everybody.